Let's talk underlying systemic cause of chronic migraines after this. Kat Matlock here at FreeBody. You are in the headaches playlist, and I feel it really important to speak to an underlying cause of chronic migraines that's just starting to get more attention, and I believe was the cause of my chronic migraines growing up as a child. When I was growing up, I had migraines, terrible migraines, and then whenever I was menstruating, TMI maybe, I would really have terrible migraines. And so if you're having hormonally related migraines, you're really going to want to pay attention to this video right here. See, there's more and more research coming out about histamine. Now, we tend to associate histamine with a runny nose, stuffiness, seasonal allergies, and yes, histamine can cause all of those things. But more and more research is coming out saying that actually histamine can also, the only symptom you may have with histamine sensitivity is chronic migraines. So I want to explain to you a little bit about my understanding of how histamine causes chronic headaches and migraines. See, histamine isn't just signaling your body to make your nose run. Histamine is a neurotransmitter. And what it's saying to your body is there's something here that doesn't belong. And that could be seasonal, it could be pollen, it could be food that you're taking into your body. So if you also maybe have some digestive issues, some bloating, some irritable bowel syndrome, some other kinds of food sensitivities, histamine is definitely at play. Histamine signals your brain that there's some kind of danger to your body, to your system. And it doesn't necessarily know what it is. It's just saying there's something going on that I don't like. And what that does is a couple things, and it will signal a stress response. So histamine can can feed into anxiety and chronic stress. Now, when we go into a stress response, our body sets off an inflammatory response. So your chronic migraines may be a result of histamine triggering a stress response in your body, because your body's like, something's going on, there's an invader of some sort, we need to get all hands on deck and protect this body. Now, here's something really curious. Histamine creating a stress response will activate tension in the muscles at the base of your skull. Those are the suboccipital muscles. And when those muscles get tense, you might feel your head go like this, or you might feel a headache that starts at the base of your skull and wraps around your head like a vice. Also, if there are other trigger points in your muscles already, kind of latent trigger points that aren't causing pain, but if your muscles of your neck and shoulders are holding some tension, that histamine trigger is going to turn up the tension in those muscles and maybe send you into a headache. So histamine is really something that you might want to take a look at. You might have chronic headache, chronic migraines, you might have some digestive sensitivities or issues, you might have seasonal allergies, or you might have headaches that are only associated with your menstrual cycle. And if those are the case, that could mean that you might have an overabundance of histamine or going on in your system, or you just aren't able to process the histamine in your body. That's a whole big other conversation that we could talk about for a really long time. But I wanted to put this out to you because I think it's important to understand that one of the main causes of chronic migraines is histamine. So, I recommend that you see someone, a doctor, an acupuncturist, someone who can understand, and you want to know that they understand histamine. It is a growing body. There is a growing body of research looking at histamine and how it causes chronic migraines, as well as a whole host of other things, like it can affect your thyroid gland. It could be at play in rheumatoid arthritis. It can be at play with any kind of arthritis. So not just allergies. So I really hope that this information is helpful and kind of opens a new door for you to understand, because once I got histamine under control and my daughter, who also has some histamine sensitivity, once we got that under control, she stopped having migraines completely and she stopped having issues around her menstrual cycle. It also significantly brought down stress and anxiety in her life and also in mine. And so if you're noticing that your headaches are relative to things that you eat or relative to how much stress you're feeling, and sometimes you might be feeling stress like that doesn't even make sense. Like, I think I'm fine, but I just feel agitated. That could be a signal that you have too much histamine in your nervous system, in your body. One more piece. In the Chinese medicine understanding of how we process different chemistry in our bodies, there's like a clock, and at certain times of day, your liver is getting cleansed and your kidneys are getting cleansed at another hour. Histamine processing time in the human system is from about 3 to 4 a.m. So if you are also having headaches and waking up in the middle of the night, maybe having nightmares, maybe having a stress response, you wake up and you're kind of afraid or you're angry, that means that your body is processing a lot of histamine perhaps at that time of night. So something to think about. I really hope that this helped you. Leave me a comment and let me know if that was like, that's totally a new thing that I didn't know about. And if you're interested, we can continue this conversation. I just wanted to throw that out for you. So I hope that's helpful. Kat here at FreeBody. Thanks for being here. I'll see you next time.